comic books sure are exciting. But not nearly as exciting as sitting down and planning out the perfect way to protect your favorite standard-sized trading card game pieces, such as Magic the Gathering, Pokemon, Flesh and Blood, and at least one more. But if you both play those games and are a fan of the comic books, then maybe you would like to show that fanaticism on your card sleeves. Currently, two major sleeve manufacturers are offering card sleeves illustrated with characters and emblems from Marvel and DC comic books. So I suppose it's Marvel versus DC, or more accurately, GameGenic versus Arcane Tinman. Let's begin. The Marvel artwork sleeves from GameGenic were actually made for the game Marvel Champions, which if you have not already played, I cannot recommend enough. Check it out, it's a lot of fun. However, since they were designed specifically for this game and not tournament play, such as Magic the Gathering and Pokemon players are going to experience, they may not have been made with the same standards those players would expect. However, I have had multiple requests to review these. They are standard sized for Magic and Pokemon cards, and so I'm going to let you know how well they hold up and what their strengths and weaknesses are. Right off the bat, I really like the art and design choice that GameGenic has on display here. As opposed to the literal movie photographs that are on the DC sleeves, as we'll see in a minute, these instead bear the faces and emblems of the Marvel characters in an illustrated comic book fashion. And while they do have to have the Marvel logo, it is small and non-intrusive. The sleeves back are more of a brushed texture, definitely not glossy, but it doesn't have that nice stippled matte quality that many sleeves have. The fronts of the sleeves are clear and transparent. I did notice in testing a very minor tendency to scuff, but I'll talk about shuffling in just a moment. These are compatible with double sleeving, or of course can be used for single sleeving as seen here, and are sold in packs of 50 for $7.99 each. This again is a side effect of them being designed for the Marvel Champions game, no doubt, so you'd have to buy two packs for a Commander deck, or two packs for a standard Pokemon or Magic the Gathering deck, meaning that you're likely dropping $15 to $16 on these sleeves. Luckily, they are tough and durable. Why, you might even say that the Hulk himself would have trouble smashing these. I've seen a Marvel movie. Unfortunately, not even Captain America could keep his cool while trying to shuffle with these, as they have an incredibly poor feel. There is absolutely no glide to them during a mass shuffle. Feels like two pieces of sandpaper rubbing against one another. And this, of course, leads to those scuffs I was talking about earlier, as well as bent corners and other marks upon the cards. This is without a doubt the worst aspect of these sleeves. It's really too bad because there's a lot of great features about these cards. If it weren't for the shuffle feel, then I might say that we had a very good or even excellent sleeve, but that holds it back by a lot. And when you compare them to the DC sleeves, oh my goodness, these glide like butter. Smooth, silky, beautiful matte art back and clear fronts. These quite possibly have the greatest shuffle feel of any sleeve ever, and it's no wonder because a close inspection of the box reveals that, while nowhere indicated on the front or sides, these are the same as Dragon Shield matte art sleeves, made by Arcane Tinman, the company that makes Dragon Shields. While the packaging is devoid of the term Dragon Shield, you can tell from the top and the bottom, and of course the box design itself, that these are essentially Dragon Shield DC character art matte sleeves. And in my extensive testing of them, I cannot tell the difference between these and the actual named Dragon Shield matte arts, which of course are my favorite sleeve ever. Goodness, I guess the Batman isn't the only one with a secret identity. These are really Dragon Shields. The artwork is actually printed onto the sleeve, so there's no possibility of peeling or scratching off. It's got a real crisp, wonderful resolution. I don't personally like that they used actual photos of the actors. I would have preferred an illustration of the comic book characters, but I suspect this was firmly tied into the recent movie of the Justice League, and so that's why they used actual photos of the actors. But the imagery is crisp, clear, not blurred at all, excellent resolution, and on top of all of that, you've got Dragon Shield durability and that wonderful matte texture. You can double sleeve with ease or just use these for single sleeving as well. And they come in boxes of 100, usually with a few extras thrown in, at a price of about $11.99 here in the States. In the past, one of the problems that Dragon Shield style sleeves had was with double sleeving. Wasn't a major issue, but as anyone knows from that era, double sleeving could be difficult as the tightness of the outer sleeve would sometimes have the inner sleeve ride up off of the card. This is still sometimes the case with the regular Dragon Shield mats, but I've found with this art mat formula, they seem to have just the right configuration for double sleeving so that it's a breeze. Look at how easy it is for me to push the card into the sleeve and not have the inner sleeve ride up at all. Really helps reduce stress when you're sleeving up 100 cards for Commander. And I always like how Dragon Shield usually throws a few extra sleeves in just in case one splits. But as you know, splitting and Dragon Shield is not a common occurrence, and just as with their regular matte and art matte sleeves, not to mention their glossies and other giant library of styles, these are extremely durable and some of the thickest sleeves on the market. So I guess it is appropriate to have the Man of Steel himself represented on these Dragon Shield sleeves. Why, you'd think they were made on Krypton and not in Denmark. So while I dare not venture into the battle of Marvel versus DC in terms of character and story, I can say that when speaking strictly in a sense of quality, DC sleeves by Dragon Shield win here, but GameGenic's offering is not outright terrible. The biggest problem is just their shuffle feel, and I suppose price being what it is not great. I'm still going to give them a C+, and I'll fully acknowledge that I much prefer their choice in artwork. I hope very much this video has been of some help to you. If you'd like to see my other card sleeve review videos, deck box review videos, playmat review videos, binders and binder sheet review videos, or just check out my favorite products and accessories, take a look at the description of this video for those playlists. And when it is possible, if it is possible, if it is reasonable and especially safe to do so, when you spend your money on Magic the Gathering, Pokemon, or Flesh and Blood, try and spend it where you spend time playing this great game. And that is at your local game store. You're supporting your community.
Can I call you back? I just ran into an old friend.
Professor! You paisley old rogue!
Teferi, you guy that I like.